What about like before you audition or whatever?
Before I audition,
how do you get pumped for an audition, or how do you get in the zone for an audition?
That's a good question. You know, I really don't have anything specific I do. Like sometimes I read with people, sometimes I don't. I always like to read with people, like to get ready if I can.
Yeah.
I feel like that's helpful. I know that there is a logic behind never reading with a person because you don't know if you can count on that opportunity before audition. You don't want to rely on it.
Sure.
But it's just like, if I have it, of course I'll take it. Yes, of course it's more useful to have somebody to prompt my lines than just kind of memorizing them in a vacuum.
Yeah.
But like, I don't have like a special drink. Sometimes I listen to music in the car, but a lot of times it's just silence and just me just like going over my lines, you know. I honestly like to go over my lines all the way up to entering the room. I love
it. Oh, really?
Yeah, I do. Like, I just, you know, because there's always, I want it to feel so much like an organic, like I want it to be muscle memory.
Yeah.
You know, and like that takes a bit of time to do that, you know.
Yeah.
Like I'm not like an audition savant.
Sure.
You know, like, and so it's just like I want it to feel as natural as possible. So I want it to feel like I'm reciting it as if they were the only thoughts I organically had. And so to help do that, like, yeah, why not take every second I can? I mean, it's not for everyone, I know. I know a lot of people need to center and focus, you know, but I like to. Here's another fun thing about me. I like to hear the auditions.
Oh,
I know a lot of people
what?
Don't like that. I love it. It makes me feel cool, like, and calm when I can hear, like, the door is like not well insulated.
Yeah.
And I can hear other people auditioning. I love it.
I have so many thoughts. First off, I memorize or I run lines up until the thing too, but I hate that I do it. Because I'm like, I have it, and now this is just getting in my psyche. I feel that's important for you to know. Yeah,
like,
but I feel like if I trip up right beforehand, I'm like, oh, I don't have it. And I think that can fuck me up.
Yeah.
So it's interesting. I do it, but I don't enjoy doing it. And then hearing people, nobody likes hearing people. I don't like hearing it, but I do use it to my advantage. I feel like a lot of people try to block it out, and I'm like, fuck that. Let me get that intel, yo.
Yeah. So you do like hearing it.
I don't like hearing it because it gets in my head again.
Mm, all right.
I like to not be in my head before these things. That's why I take a breath.
Yeah.
And I like to use if I can hear a note they're getting or whatever, I love that. But
ooh,
I don't like hearing them do it because then I'm like, wait, they're doing it completely different than me. I'm doing it wrong, obviously.
Oh, no, I don't feel that way. I love it when people are doing it completely different than me because I'm like, oh, good, I am original. You know, like, I love
or
it.
Or you could be wrong, though.
I could. You know what? Here's the thing, though. I could be wrong. Yes, absolutely. But, like, here's the thing is that, like, it's so easy to forget, you know? So it's like, I'm really confident about this logic right now, you know, and you pop me in a room the next day, I'm going to be like, oh boy, I hope they like me, you know? And like all my confidence is just like, where did it go? But like the idea being is that, you're never going to be a better Mike, you know, sorry, no one is going to be a better Mike than you.
This?
Oh boy. Oh dear. Like no one's going to be a better mic than you,
you know?
So when you come in, you really like, you're not going to fail if you just like
bring you.
Role, I know this is like so overly stated. You've done a million of these, so I'm sure this is not the first time this has come up, but like there's so much truth.
Be.
Yeah. I mean, there's so much truth to that too, where it's just like, you know, and I tend to go out for like a large range of things too, like from like, you know, like butch biker girl to like prissy little rich girl. And I go out for a really wide range of things. And so I know that like I'm not going to be like the most quintessential prissy rich girl.
Right.
But I know that I could be Leland as one.
Right.
You know, and so if I prepare that and it's so different from like what other people are doing, I don't feel bad because it's like no one's going to do this take better than me. You know,
right.
Like it may not be the image that they had in mind, but like, I like to think about when I prepare for auditions, I like to think if I were the producer of the show, like how would I mold me? You know?
Yeah.
Like, and that really helps me.
Yeah.
You know,
that's a great way to look at it.
Yeah.
Cause you want to convince, you want to sell them on you being in that position. That's
yes.
Great.
Because it's going to be so exhausting if I have to be somebody else.
Right.
You're like, what if I book it? Oh no. Then I have to do maybe a season if I'm lucky too, like of a person that I like, I'm like, oh crap, you know, like I've developed a vessel that I'm not connected to.
I
would hate that, you know? So I have to, like, I have to think about it. It's like, if I'm going to like, say, you know, like I get all my dreams come true and I book this as a series regular, I'm going to have to sustain this vessel, this thing I created forever, for every shot, for every scene, for every take, not forever. Nothing's forever, especially in this industry. but like, so I want it to be something that like I am so connected to and have so much fun with.
Right.
You know?
Right. The one Lelon.
Yeah.